It's wonderful to have you with us. Congratulations. How are you enjoying the London Film Festival?
Oh, it's fantastic. It's my third time here, so I always love coming to the festival. It's funny, as a filmmaker, when you're connected to a festival and they keep playing your films, you know, you feel really loyal to them. And so it's exciting to be part of it this year.
What's special about the London Film Festival in particular?
Look, I've always thought, you know, across the programming, you know, it's a chance to see kind of a real diverse range of kind of global cinema, like a snapshot of where the world's at. And, you know, that intrigues me, you know, like to come to one place, you know, and have, because the festival directors, I mean, Claire's done an amazing job this year. You know, you have people that do an exceptional job of that curatorial job. Kind of saves you time, I guess.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Let's talk about the film. Tell us a little bit about it for people who are looking forward to seeing it.
Well, Underground is the story of Julian Assange as a 19-year-old, you know, so it takes this man who's world-renowned for creating Wikileaks, but looks at him as a kid, you know, looks at him as a 17, 18, 19-year-old. So, you know, it's set 2 years before the internet, you know, it's at a time when, you know, the world is shifting from activism on the street to the beginning of this new era of activism online. You know, and it's a thriller, it's a fun thriller, you know, with an amazing performance from this young kid playing Assange.
And in terms of research for something so current and sort of that is still such a hot potato, how did you go about that?
I was very lucky to have access to a book called Underground, written by Suelette Dreyfus, who worked with Julian Assange. And it's about hacking in that era. Like, it's a great, terrific book, actually, dealing with, you know, what was going on. You know, how were people hacking 2 years before the internet? I think having that kind of historic document to underpin it was fantastic.
Did you have access to Julian himself?
I did, but I didn't choose to go there. I didn't want it to be the approved version. You know, I wanted it to be the kind of unauthorized. I didn't think audiences would want to see something approved. And with great respect for him, he was quite happy for that. He kind of understood that and, you know, allowed us to go over there and make it, which I think was a great result for everyone.
Now, in terms of casting, let's talk about the performances. I mean, what did they bring to the film?
Well, Alex Williams, this young kid, you know, his first job out of acting school, he went to the acting school that Hugh Jackman went to in West Australia, and he's fantastic as Assange. His mother's played by Rachel Griffiths, an Australian actress kind of quite well world-renowned, and the cop that hunts them is played by Anthona LaPaglia, and Anthony starred in my two previous films, Balibo and the Bank, both which played at the London Film Festival. We were here together with the Bank in 2001 and Balibo in 2009. So it's a great cast.
And in terms of the casting process, how difficult was that, particularly to pick who played Julian?
Yeah, how do you cast the young Julian Assange? You know, it's a real challenge, you know. And so you want someone who's intelligent, and you have to believe when you look at their performance that they could one day go on and form Wikileaks, you know. So that's a trick, you know. You've really got to, you know, I mean, obviously he's got a kind of high IQ, you know. So I was lucky I found this kid. And so my first principle was, let's not worry too much about finding someone who looks like him. Let's try and find the best actor first. And then this young kid came in an audition, and he looked like him, and he was intelligent, you know, and a movie star. You know, he's we played at the Toronto Film Festival before London, and he got snapped up by American agents, and, you know, watching his career take off. So I think that, you know, I was really lucky to find him, you know. And I look at the film, I go, God, you know, if I didn't have an actor as good as him, would it work?
Why did you think it was important to tell this story, and did you have any reservations about doing it now?
No, I was excited to do it now. You know, I really think that, you know, the world is shifting, and that individuals within democracies, you know, in a worldwide movement, are demanding more transparency from their governments. You know, my own political view is that no matter what happens to WikiLeaks, you know, the US government's clearly trying to destroy it. You know, there's lots of moves afoot to crush it. I think they're missing the point. You know, I think they're missing the point that individuals within democracies are sick and tired of having terrible things that our governments are doing hidden from us. And I think WikiLeaks, you know, in 50, 100 years from now, will be seen as the catalyst for change, regardless of, you know, what happens to it in the short term.
And in terms of what you want audiences to take away from it, to learn from it, I mean, what would you ideally like them to think when they leave the theatre?
I think my main agenda was to, because it's about a kid who's 17, you know, and I looked at that era in late 80s, and I think ultimately it's about activism. What I'd like people to take away, and a young audience, I've made it kind of young and sexy. It's an action thriller. you know, I would like young people to look at it and kind of go, yeah, activism is a powerful force. Yeah, it's good to stand up for what you believe. You can make a difference. I think the worst thing that can happen is that individuals start believing that they're just a cog in a big machine, and that whereas this is about, you know, individualism. You know, I think we see that in the Occupy Wall Street movement. You know, I think, you know, that hopefully the film throws down the gauntlet to younger people.
And you personally, what are you working on next?
I'm working on a film called The Turning, which is a compendium of short films. I bought a book of short stories, an Australian book of short stories, and invited a lot of my contemporaries to direct one each. People like Kate Blanchett's directing one. The actor David Wenham. I mean, there's a high caliber of people directing them. And they're filming at the moment. In fact, one of them's filming back in Australia as I'm here. So it's a pretty busy time.
Well, congratulations on the film. Thank you so much.
Thanks.